Alright, good evening guys, this is Piteio from the 9th Age Forum, from the tool support team, and in this video I wanted to briefly show you how you can use Universal Battle 2 Pro features to speed up the your gaming experience. So let's assume that you have a Pro account, you can use your username and your password to sign in. And once you have signed in, you can create your own army, okay? And the process to do this is to click on Edit Armies, to go on your armies with this icon here, this profile, and then click on this plus here that allows you to create a new army, all right? You give a name to the new army, and you click on the plus here to create a new model. Okay? So let's imagine that we want to create a clan warrior from the Dwarven Hold faction. So in order to create your model, the first thing that you do is to set the dimension of the base, which is 20 by 20 in our case. Then we can choose a color for our faction. Dwarven Holds are going to be this blue, okay. Then in here, in this top section, you can select different warriors, different weapons, and so on and so forth. So we start with a dwarf, we click on a dwarf here, and we have this preloaded image of a dwarf, and we can change the values here. For example, we can put helmets, there's a variety of things to choose from. And we can change the hair, like for the birds or everything. We can change the cloak or remove the cloak. We can change the armor to anything that we happen to like. And yeah, okay, this looks like a decent basic dwarf. You can rescale the dwarf using this section here. You can rotate the guy a bit if you feel like you need to do that, and then you can add the weapons. So for example, in our case we decided to have throwing weapons and a great weapon. So let's choose a nice axe, and let's make it so that, you know, the dwarf is carrying the axe using his shoulder as a docking point. Okay? So we rotate this thing. Sometimes it flips in the other direction when you change stuff, when you change the rotation factor and everything. I don't know what that happens, but in the end it all works out like that. So this guy is merrily carrying his great axe on his shoulder, and let's give him a throwing weapon. Once again, another axe, because these are dwarves. No, because I have no fantasy, actually. So you can rescale the thing here, and you can place it in the other hand. I mean, this is very ugly model building that I'm doing here, but it's just to give you an idea. Because, for example, you have to know another couple of things. So, for example, clan warriors, meaning that you have to give it a name. Another thing that I like to do is to add a patch, a green patch, a square one, and, you know, put it to the size of the base. And, of course, we don't want it to be on top of the dwarf, but below the dwarf. So we use this layer index here, right? Like that. And in this way, we have created our clan warrior model, okay? Now, this is feature number one, creating your own models and saving them in your army. Now, The second thing that I wanted to show you, there are three things that I want to show you in this video. The second thing that I want to show you is how you can copy one of the models that I have made for you to use and possibly to translate as well. And this is something that you can also do with a pro account. So creating your own models, cloning models that somebody else has done. So if you go in this tab here with the presets armies, you can scroll down and find my army called Veil of the Ages, like this channel. You click on it and you see a variety of, you know, of guys here, the models that I have created for this army. You select on one, and this is for example the Necropolis Guard, and you can clone it. And once you clone it, you have a list of your own armies, and as you remember, this is the one that we just created. You clone it here, and then you can go back to your new army, and you are going to find not only the model that we just created, but also the one that we just cloned, the Necropolis Guard here. By the way, this is the Necropolis Guard, this is not the Guardia della Necropoli. So if you want to translate this, you just go here, click on the name, and you change the name, right? Very easy. And of course, you can also translate the notes. So you click on here, non morto is going to be undead. And here you can select, yeah, advance, march, discipline, reanimate, health points, defense. You might want to add a space or two to make things fit. Resilience, armor, attacks, number of attacks, NA, no, attack, offense, strength, space, armor penetration, and agility. Looks good the way it does. Okay, and you can save the changes as they are. Another thing that you can do is to select this, copy it with Control C on a Windows computer. You save it here. You go back to the dwarf that you just created. You click on the info button and you paste the information here. Now, of course, this dude does not have undead. It also doesn't have any reanimation value. What's the profile of a clan warrior? Gosh, this feels like an exam. Everybody's gonna laugh at me if I get something wrong, right? I think this is the heavy armor. Offense is 4, strength is 5, because they have a great weapon, armor piercing 2, but agility is 0, and then we add the throwing weapons. Hitting on a 4 plus, 2 shots, range 8, strength as user, which means 3 in this case, because 5 is the one from the great weapon. Now we close and we save. We can set this army as our default army, and next time we create a match, okay, like this one here, we can click on this button here and add units from our newly created army, like clan warriors in 5x3, and you place it on the field, and then Necropolis Guard 5x3. Ah, I put two rows for the other ones. That's okay, doesn't matter, right? And then in this way you get ready for some epic action between the dwarves and the dynasties, right? So this was the second feature that I wanted to show you, how to clone a model from a pre-existing army. And the third feature that I wanted to show you that you can have with the pro account is this save and load possibility here. Okay, you can save the army that you have just created in a new slot like this one here, give it a name, and it's going to be saved for you to use, right? Test okay. And now if I delete this thing, okay, I can simply go to the load functionality here, and I am going to select this test thing. You load from the slot, and what you get is your army with the two units and with all the information that we just put in there. Okay. Now, why is this interesting? Well, of course, because you can save a game when you have to interrupt the playing because your opponent or you have to interrupt the game, it's too late, anything. Several reasons for interrupting a game. But it's also interesting to set up a game because, for example, I have prepared for my own account this loaded army here, this loaded game, and if I load from this slot, I have everything available at once. I have the terrain, I have the hourglass, the flux cards, and I have my four armies already preloaded here. This is Equiten, then we have the Warriors of the Dark Gods, they're here, and we have the Sylvan Elves, and so on and so forth. And so, for example, if I decide that my game is going to be Warriors of the Dark Gods versus Sylvan Elves, I'm just going to take the other two armies that are preloaded and, you know, just kill them. And now I'm ready to do my my deployment. Okay? And then if I have to interrupt the game at turn two, I just save it again, and the next day I start again by loading it. Okay? So this is all I had to say for this video. I hope you find it useful, and yeah, let's hope we meet on the battlefield at some point. Bye. Ciao, guys.